Hello, everybody. If anybody's out there, can you hear me? Make sure everything's working. All right, camera's good. Yo, Dennis. Hey, can you hear me okay? Dennis, my brother from another mother. Sweet. All right. Cool. Here we go. So, what is that? All right, hold on. We are having some malfunctions here. Here we go. Okay. So, got some things on the agenda for today. First thing I want to do is, again, shout out the Tulsa show. 2022, Saturday, June 11th at the Marriott Tulsa Hotel in Southern Hills. Friday, June 10th is going to be the hospitality reception, 7 p.m. to 11 p.m., room 306. Tulsa show, the registration is 8 a.m. to noon. It'll be open to the public, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. There's a silent auction running from noon to 4 p.m. Awards ceremony at 4:30 p.m. All right, so if you're in the Tulsa area and you want to meet the Fred Brush in person, come on by. Next. All right, let's see if I can do this. We're trying new things here. Here we go. All right, the Tulsa Modelers Forum. All right, does a show every year in Bixby, Oklahoma. All right, this is the first year they've had it since 2019, I believe, okay? It is on for this year. Route 66 Model Expo, April 9th, 2022, at the Bixby Community Center, 211 North Cabanas, Bixby, Oklahoma. All right. The theme this year is Made in Japan. All right. It does not have to be a kit that was manufactured in Japan. If it, Gundams, military vehicles, anything that has to do with being made in Japan. I've thought about doing a Godzilla. Okay, so that's how open it is. Okay, ignore the date. That's when they were going to do it in 2020, but it got canceled. Let's see here. Let's open up one of the flyers. See if we can get some times here. Here we go. Free to the public. Registration is 9 a.m. to noon. They usually... Now, this one's kind of cool because I want to say starting at about 12... They actually do a raffle every 30 minutes until the awards ceremony. So a chance to get a lot of stuff there. Believe me. Oh, look, they got the right date. Nope, that's... Yeah, there we go. Saturday, April 9th. Okay, that's the right date. Okay. So I'll be entering about three or four things in this. So if you want to meet the Fred Brush in person, all right, Bixby, Oklahoma, Saturday, April 9th, 2022. So if you're watching this April 8th, 2023, there's no guarantees, okay? Now, on to some cool stuff. I have some acquaintances that have some Kickstarters starting up soon, okay? One of them is Moxie the Brutal, okay? And let me see if I can do this right. Here we go. Here is the link to the Kickstarter page, and if you click on that link, it should bring you here, okay? The Kickstarter has not started yet. I believe it starts April 11th, okay? But what I need you to do, if you're watching this before April 11th, okay, I need you to come up here and click on this little notify me on launch button, all right? Trying to get the word out there for the people. Now, this is a Kickstarter that's being put on by Secret Forge. Here they are. Secret Forge, all right? They also have a web store, campsite, okay? Let me see if this is right. Bam, there we go. All right, you can go there, check out their store, all right? So when you head over there, I've got a Discord too. I do not have my Discord in streamer mode right now. Let me see. We might have to do the Discord next stream. Hold on a second. Let me look at something real quick. Who's this? That's me. Okay. Yeah, I don't think. Wife, are you on here? I don't know if wife's here. I'll see if wife can throw it up there for me when she gets on. We'll try to figure out a way. Some good people there. As far as I know, this is their first Kickstarter they're doing. So let's go out and show them our support. All right. Now, as you can see in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen is a Raphael Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. This is by Michel Ballares of Creative Geek MB. So we'll go ahead, and this should contain his social medias. All right. So be sure and go check him out. All right. He does some amazing, amazing sculpts. Okay. So what we're going to be working on today is the Raphael that he did. Okay. Now, as you can see from the photo in the bottom left, that Raphael has a mask. Mine does not. I'm thinking about doing the mask. It is its own separate print. Okay. And this was 3D printed. I printed this on my Elegoo Mars 2 Pro. Okay. I really like the way it looks with the mask. So I think we're going to do what we can today. And I think the mask might come at a later date. I think if this goes into a contest or goes up on the shelf to be displayed, then the mask will be part of it. I did some zenithal priming on this to maybe help it show up on camera a little better. I think it does. This is really a great sculpt. Ah, hi, there's wife. This is really a great sculpt. And I did the zenithal prime a little bit different this time. I don't have the black I used in here because it is in the garage. It's from a rattle can. But I used a Wow, okay. I know Twitch was talking about they were doing away with the desktop app. I didn't realize it was this soon. Maybe it was April 1st. I don't know. So I did black, and it's a it's not a normal black primer. I can't think of what it's called. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So then to do the other part of the zenithal, I went at a 45-degree angle with Ocean Blue from Steinorez. It says the 30th, but would not show your live video. Oh, well, I don't know. Maybe Twitch just doesn't like me. That's cool. They're not the only ones. So I did 45-degree with the blue. And then I went from 90 degrees with Liquitex white ink. Okay? So I think I like this priming method better. I don't use glazes, really. So a zenithal prime doesn't necessarily help me, except maybe for a reference photo after while I'm painting. But I did this because I thought maybe it would show it better on the video, and I think it does. I like it. It looks good. All right, now things look a little bit different today. Okay, here we go. We've got the wet palette. All right, now I know I've been doing everything in oils recently. Oh, nice. Good. Notification came through on the phone. Nice. Good, good. So what we're going to do is, let me get my little paper towel here. We're going to do things a little bit different this time. Usually I had been just going and doing the primer. Doing my normal black primer to help fill in, you know, lay lines and stuff on the print, and then going over it with a mixture of Procure Prime, their white, and their dark neutral gray, giving it a real light layer over there. But and then going over that with the straight with the pre-glaze of the oils, then breaking out the sponges and going that route to start kicking it off with the oils. I'm going to do this one a little bit different. We have our prime. However, this time we are going to do some base coating with acrylics first. And then we're going to see about doing some oils over top of it. So I've got the same reference photo on the screen that I'm going off of. So hopefully get some colors nailed down. Actually, I think y'all can see more than I can. Okay, there we go. All right. Matter of fact, I don't know. You might be able to see them or not. I don't know how big the picture looks on y'all screen. But I gave the links to Michel Ballares' Creative Geek MB stuff. But it also has his names down at the bottom of the picture. There's his Facebook or Instagram, his Art Station, and his Patreon. So you can find it by using those names. But just in case, I'll go ahead and put the links one more time. There's those. And remember, if you ever go to anybody that I talk about on my stream, be sure and tell them the Frayed Brush sent you. You heard about it from me, all right? And let them know how we do things here. All right, so let's see here. We're going to go ahead and start with green because, like other painting, we start at the lowest layer working our way up, and the lowest layer is skin, and turtles are green. So let's see what we got here. We've got some, I'm going to be using Chimera colors. Wow, that is really, really dark. That's actually a green. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can get all technical and like mess with white balance or something and get this figured out. Nope, that's autofocus. We don't want to mess with that. Here we go. Okay, that's totally not the right camera, but apparently we needed to work with that one too. That was good. All right, now. Ooh. Man, this is. That might be about as close as we get, ladies and gentlemen. That's a little bit better. All right, we'll go with that. Ooh, wow, that looks like. Look like I ate too many carrots. But it's green. We'll try it. We'll see what it looks like. Let's see. Oh, goodness. No, we can't do that. Hold on. Actually, that might look pretty good to y'all. It might be the difference in screens. All right, we're sticking with it. All right, so we're going to shake this up. Remember, Chimera colors, okay? They all come with a mixing ball in them, which is amazing, okay? Now, my acrylic paints have not been used in about two months. So there's hard telling what they're going to look like coming out of this bottle. Hopefully usable. Hopefully they look usable. We're good. That's usable. That's totally usable. All right. Now, we want to use one of our good brushes here. And remember, these are acrylic paints, so we can lick the brush. All right. This is a Raphael 8404 size 2. All right. Wife got me this for Christmas. And we're going to start painting some green. It's been a while, so all we're really shooting for is smooth base coats. All right. We'll start at the top. And we want to get full coverage, all right? I don't use glazes. And it's a little bit thinner than what I want. Been so long since I've used acrylics, I feel like I'm painting with them for the first time. They do not carry as far as oils do, that's for sure. Oil paint, you can pretty much take one brush full and put it over the whole thing. Not today. Not today. Hope everybody's having a good weekend. I know this is not my normal stream time of Sunday afternoons at 2, but I have a church function tomorrow that could run past 2 o'clock, and I would rather change the stream date than try to do it later in the day on a Sunday. Acrylics is they dry fast, and word on the street is we can put the oils right on top of them. We'll see how it goes. My goal is to get these base coats laid down and then proceed to do the pre-glaze as normal. So put the base coats down and then pick up the oil process from the beginning. Acrylics are not so forgiving. Acrylics are not as forgiving as oils. Because oils, if you get one color on another color, you just take a different brush and wipe it off. Acrylics, not quite so simple. Maybe some people, not to me. Excuse me. All right. It's been a while since I streamed on a Saturday. I don't even know who I'm going to raid at the end. I'm sure we'll find somebody. Hey, and you know, I've been putting some stuff on got some of my projects up on putty and paint. And I've seen a few people recently using ArtStation. And it looks like there might be a change from putty and paint. I might switch my stuff over to ArtStation. Seems like it's used a lot more. there's any painters out there, let me know what you think about Art Station if you're on it. And if you've never seen putty and paint before, let's see if this works. Hey, there we go. I think I've got two or three projects up there that I've painted. They're not very, I guess, finished. Pictures. The projects themselves are finished, but I am lacking in the photography department. This model printed in 12 different pieces. It was the upper body, the skirt, the legs, the hands, the shell, the lamp, and two parts to the base. So it wasn't too terribly awful. Wasn't bad. And this is printed at 50% size. So I scaled it down to fit on my printer. Later this month, I'll be picking up a Photon Mono X, so stuff like this, should be able to be done at full size and potentially in one piece, which I'm hoping will help out. We'll see. What's sweet? Also, if anybody out there has social medias that pertain to 3D printing or painting, anything like that, feel free to drop links in the chat. Please limit it to 3D printing and painting. So Dennis, I know you just picked up your oils. What is the first thing you're going to paint with oils? Mm-hmm. is. Alright, that's alright. We'll be lighting it back up with highlights and such. It's okay. Before I glue it together, might be the way to go. I've seen the thing pop up that they're doing it. I haven't clicked on it to see the reasoning behind it. Me and wife were kind of talking about that last night, about possible reasons. If anybody here knows, please feel free to drop the reason in chat. But I don't think we ever really came up with a good reason why they would do it. Can y'all hear the music? I got music going. I don't know if y'all can hear it or not. I have to wear headphones to hear it, so I don't wear it. I don't wear my headphones, so I kind of throw my headphones on long enough to make sure it's going, and then take my headphones off. But if that music is too loud, anything like that, just let me know. I can try to turn it down or turn it off, whichever. It's not like too loud or nothing, is it? Oh, wow. I might need to turn that up a little bit, though, because I think I'm talking pretty loud. Let me see if I can turn my... Oh, man. I'm on a public forum. Otherwise, I would address that. Let me see here. I have no way... All right, so according to this, my mic volume's all the way up. Yep, So that's what we're stuck with. Wow. I don't know. I need to adjust my mic. I need to adjust mic and cameras. The to-do list. Adjust. Whoa. Name of that song is Sexy Time. Uh-oh. It says save for Twitch, so... There's some finicky spots in here. Wife, are you playing Elden Ring? You know, I wonder how much oil paints would cover up a lot of these brush strokes. I don't know if y'all can see them on your screen, but there are brush strokes, just so you know. Also, you want to be sure and if you're not following, go ahead and give a follow, because word on the street is coming up soon, the frayed brush could be doing some stuff that not everybody else is doing in the painting world. So stay tuned for that. Be sure you follow. Where you can keep abreast of what's going on in my world. And for the people that are here, do y'all like having the reference photo in the corner that kind of shows you what I'm looking at while I paint? I always don't have something, but I just happened to this time. But is that something y'all want to continue seeing, or does it just not matter either way? Or is anybody even watching? People just listening? Some stuff I paint doesn't have, like, concept art. Alright, Dennis. Some of the 3D sculptors I deal with don't do color concepts. So a lot of time it just doesn't make sense for me to put up a black and white picture on something that I'm painting, because then it really doesn't do anybody any good. Do it now, act fast, surrender. Oh. Yeah, sometimes I've got some things coming up where it'll be a lot easier to do my own thing, but it seems like recently I've been doing a lot of like comic book characters and stuff like that. So they're expected to be done a certain way, but might have some things coming up soon where there's some artistic freedom. Which, for you all that don't know, if there's any time I do something where I have to choose the colors, I actually make my wife choose the colors for me. So she's a much, much better color picker than I am. If y'all that don't know or haven't caught on yet, Evil Barbie is his wife. Can't hear me. Man, I don't know. I don't feel like I'm talking that low. I'll tell you what. Let me finish these toes. And I'm going to try to adjust the mic real quick. Adjust real quick. There's some green up under his skirt. Let's see if we can. I don't even know if there's any. Well, yeah, we can do this part right here. You can see that. Take your words back home. Back way nice and slow. Feel the ebb and flow. Please get sucked out to sea. Wonder where you are, 'cause you know it take these things kinda extra hard. This back and forth won't take me anywhere I need to be. I can't meet you anymore. Alright, I think that's all the green for now. Pretty sure. Set him to the side, and then let's adjust this mic real quick. All right, camera's gonna shake for a minute. It'll be okay though. How does that sound? Hopefully that's better. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is... Okay, good. Now what we need to do is we're going to go next layer up, which will be the breast And yeah, probably so. I can believe that. We're gonna go with the breast and abdomen, and we'll go ahead and do the shell since it has something over top of it. Since technically in this area the shell is the lower level. So what we want to do now, we're gonna be darkening this down even more when we put the oil wash on it. So we'll do. Let's see here. What do we got? Honeymoon yellow and yellow oxide. We'll go with the honeymoon yellow. Like not honeymoon like married, honeymoon like honeymoon yellow. And we'll do the chest armor and the little buckler on the left arm the same colors. They'll both be this color. Cruddy. Alright. So ooh, that is see-through. That is some transparent paint right there. Goodness. That's going to take a couple layers. I got some extra water on the brush. All right, let's... I didn't notice that the breast, the buckler has a little face in it. Yeah, that's gonna take a couple coats. But we'll get the first one on. Then we'll do the breast and the abdomen. And then we'll come back for the second coat. Now, in a perfect world, I would have took care of that wrapping first, but, you know, it is what it is. Sucks, okay, sucks. Do. Now I'm hoping that we'll get these base coats put on. Then we'll hit it with that pre-glaze the oil, and it'll be like, magic, done. But I don't think it's going to work out that way. But we'll see what happens. Okay. Probably should add a touch of white to that to help it cover. If you ever need to help a light color cover, add some white to it. It's worth it. All right. I know this is some stark contrast here, but just hang with me. We'll both see what happens. I think what we'll do this time, so I can try to pick out as many of these details as possible, is I think we might try to do our pre-gaze a little thinner. That way it just kind of wipes off, but stays in those recesses. It really pulls out that detail. Some really fine details to get in here and get. But I think in order to make it look right, we need to have pretty much base coat on everything. Looks like his bones on his knees are the same thing. I'll do those the same color. And I thought about doing this in like a grimdark or Blanchitsu style, but I don't. When I thought about it, the more I realized I'd never tried that before, and I didn't really want to. I didn't really want to try it the first time on stream. Some things I'll do for the first time on stream, other things I think need to be practiced before brought public. That way, in case there's any questions, I'd be a little bit more prepared to answer them. Alright, got that. Now, according to the picture, kind of looks like the straps are like brown, and the shell is kind of a reddish brown, and then there's a couple of different reds. I'm gonna do the lamp and the base concrete. We might embellish that R a little bit, make it stand out a little bit more. Let's do the wraps now. And for the wraps, actually, kind of like this color right here for the shadow. Royal brown. Oh, is this one of their transparents? I wonder if that was the problem with that. I don't remember which ones were transparents. Some of them were transparents. Maybe this is one. All right. We're going for it. That's the reddish brown color we need. Yep, I think that'll look good. Let's see here. Yep, I like that. And that's gonna look good. I'm not too worried about filling in the grooves between the different segments of shell, because that will get covered up with the oil pre-glaze. So those will fill in nicely. It gives that shadow in the recesses we're looking for. And then as far as acrylics go, another good thing about these chimeric colors is how matte they dry. And they really matte down, which is what we want. And of course, with the Zenithal Prime, this looks darker as well. Because doing a Zenithal Prime, this part is almost in full shadow, so. I really like this color. It's a really nice color. It's the first time I've ever used it. Apparently it's a really good turtle shell color. Who would think it? This is a good way to see how Zenithal priming does have an effect, because you can actually see how it's lighter like in here than it is down here, and that's because of pretty much the underpainting of the primer. kind of a tricky area to get to right here. I think that's all the show. What are we gonna do next? Let's do the darker red. I will do. Let's do the bandages or the wrappings. Do the wrappings first. These are gonna be a darker brown. So, we'll go with, we'll go oxide brown dark. Hey, welcome back. Dennis, did that happen to be the barbecue you were so excited to tell me about earlier? This isn't super dark, but this will darken up with the pre-glaze, so we're good. Ooh, that sounds good. That sounds good. I'm trying to do these base coats quick because I'm really hoping the oil will put in some work on them. We'll see what happens though. I tell you, if you've never seen what happens when we go to do that oil pre-glaze, it's magic. It is magic. Hopefully it's magic. Size here. Little buckle right there. I didn't notice before. We'll have to remember to get that when we do our metallics. We'll go back in with our metallics. Hopefully we don't forget. I'm not sure if anybody just looking at it would even pick that up though. And you know, I'm not being super clean with these base coats either, because I mean they're gonna get covered up and then wiped back off, so they don't have to be perfect. And this is just a way I'm trying to try and make it a little bit easier for me on the backside with the oils. I'm just going to do this strap here too, since we're here. And it's not, you know, me being able to accomplish that with the oils isn't, it's not an issue with the oils. It's definitely an issue with me knowing them, because there are some great painters out there that have no issues with all with oils, namely James Wapple. Okay, look at these straps. So metal, maybe metal. This will be metal. Rings metal. This is metal. So those straps are almost black. I don't really want to do a black on it. So let's do Crimson.
Tell you what, we're gonna do
this violet. We're gonna take some. We're gonna take a step from oil painting here, and we're gonna use a violet and a brown to make our own black. So there's violet. Whoops. So we'll grab a little bit of this violet. And we'll grab a touch of this brown. Another touch of the brown. Goodness, that's overpowering. That's all right, we'll work with it. And we'll do these straps. That's totally purple. That's not gonna work. Alright, so what we're gonna do is what color did we do the shell in? Let's see here. Since we did some of the straps in that, we'll just do the rest of them in that oxide brown dark. Darken up with the pre-glaze. It's okay too if we get some of that regular color on our metal parts too, because the metallics will cover that up. There's actually a little bit right there I missed. Now we gotta pick these reds. So this is pigment red 3. This is pigment red 170. I think we're going to use this red for the lighter reds. And let's see. That is a little bit. We'll do the Cartacci red. One is darker than the other. Yeah, we'll use. Man, I don't know. Actually, you know what? We're going to use the Cartacci red and the crimson red. We're not going to use all of the red. Excuse me. So, we'll use the alizarin crimson first. Move that out of the way for a minute. Start getting this in here. The tail head almost turns brown over top of that that Zenithal Prime. Said before, we're not worried about necessarily perfect base coats, because there is going to be an oil pre-glaze going over top of them. We just want to make sure it's covered. And this is something I'm trying. If I don't like it, then next thing I paint will just be back to the oil pre-glaze over the primer and call it a day. I think when we go to do the pre-glaze, I think we're going to go with our normal Van Dyke brown pre-glaze. I do like the Van Dyke brown. It's been my favorite pre-glaze color so far. I tried the Terra Rosa, but I could not control that very well, so it kind of got away from me. If you happen to have seen my He-Man video, that was, I'd used a Terra Rosa on that, and looking pretty. And you know, another good thing about doing this first is if it ends up looking like completely like teetotal crap, then we can use the oils to cover everything up anyway. So we haven't necessarily lost anything, so be good. Because oils will for sure cover up acrylics if you want them to. And not even think twice about it. See if we can get inside of that a little bit. Secret Forge. What's up? Everybody, if you remember at the beginning of the stream, did the advertisement for the Moxie Kickstarter. Secret Forge just came in the chat, and that is who is doing the Kickstarter. I appreciate it. This is just some quick base coats before the oils get laid down, but I appreciate it. Oh, thank you so much, Secret Forge. Thank you very much. That is greatly appreciated. Every bit helps. To adjust my camera next time. I think the plates down here, I think we're going to go with the same color we did the shell in. We used it on the front. I want to get it, or we used it on the back. I want to get it on the front a little bit. I think those are distinct enough browns. Yeah, I might. I've been dropping it in some discords. I don't think you're a part of them. They're more specialized. Like one's my son's. He streams. Dropped it in his Discord because I'm not sure who all he has. And then I dropped it in a couple of other ones. Painting Big. That's Ann Forrester. She used to work for Reaper Miniatures. She does a bunch of freelance stuff now. And then I dropped it in Discord for Gundam Group that I'm part of. And then I also dumped it in the Discord for the modeling group that I'm a president of. Oh, you're very welcome. You're very welcome. Yeah, I'll get those Discord links shot to you. All right, so let's get some grays out here. Iron Hue it is. Almost felt dirty, easy. Wet palette paint. Oh, it's so long. Ooh. Yeah, something like that. Well, they're not scared to make decisions without me. Don't get confused. I'll tell you what, we're gonna cheat and break into the oil brushes for this because we can cover a lot of ground really fast. Yeah, I think that'd be. Yeah, you ain't got to. We'll just. You don't have to. I tell you, I think there might be a plus to doing these acrylic base coats before I lay the oil paints down, but it takes up so much more time. So much more time. It might not be worth it. This might be the last time we do this. I'm not being neat with it by any means. I mean, it's messy as hell. Yeah, again, I really appreciate you giving that gift sub. That's pretty awesome. Thank you very much. And if you are tuning in for the first time and you're seeing this going on, I'm not the best painter in the world, but I do just about guarantee you that my paintings don't look like a five-year-old did them. So rest assured, this is very early stages here. Yeah, it'll be fun. This is actually kind of the first Kickstarter that I'm in, kind of in with from the beginning. It's pretty cool. I'll tell you what, if you want to, Secret, you can go ahead and drop the link to your Discord and stuff again. I got this, let's see, here we go. There's the link to the Kickstarter. And again, here's the link to the Secret Forge web store. Now, let's see what we got for metallics here. Steel. Steel's a good color. I'll put one out there in just a minute. Oh yeah, okay. Yeah, I don't think I had the IG link. Yeah, that's kind of a personal slash family thing. We don't deal with Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, nothing like that. I'm on Discord, I'm on Twitch, and I'm on YouTube. I have no issues advertising people's stuff from those social medias. I just prefer not to have them. So, you going to the porch? Okay. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, and it's I'm not gonna lie, I'm really pleased with the communities I'm part of, especially, you know, being able to be actually listed as a content creator in some of them. It's pretty nice. It's pretty cool. We'll probably end up lightening these up a little bit once we get into the oils. Yeah, I think so. Which, Grim, Grim was actually the first one to list me as a content creator, so it was pretty cool. Owe it to him. I know my name spread around a little bit because of him. I mean, I'm by no means James Wapple or anything, but yeah, everybody starts somewhere. Yeah, hopefully it'll come together pretty fast. I don't know how much you've seen painted with oils, but it'll start taking shape pretty fast once the oils start getting put on there. No, they do not. Quite the contrary. Once I get the oils down on this guy, we're looking at, golly, depending on how thick I put the oils on, maybe 3 or 4 days to dry, somewhere around there. I'm going to have to, once I do this R, you have to let him sit for about 5 minutes or so just to make sure the the colors are set, because once those oils start going on. Oh yeah. Oh, that's the best thing about oils. Yeah, I mean, you could like, no shit, like the 3 or 4 days it takes the oils to dry, you could technically sit here and blend them the whole 3 or 4 days. Yeah, it's the acrylics are fast. And that's one good thing is about doing, there's not really any good, like, metallic oil paints. I mean, there's a few, and I'll end up breaking some of them out to touch up this. Yeah. That's the good thing about oils. That 2 day, what takes like hours and, you know, in the double digits of layers and acrylics, you can do it in 2 colors in 30 seconds with oils. It's pretty awesome. Okay, so we've got just about, well, shit, hold on. We got this little part right here. The ring there. And there. All right, so we're going to let this sit for about 5 minutes. And what I'll do, in case anybody that comes by, I'll throw it on the Moxie Kickstarter page so they can see it if they swing through here while I'm gone. But I'll be gone about 5 minutes, give this stuff time to set, and then I'll be back and we'll start kicking into the oils. So stick around, we'll be back in just a minute. All right, here we go. Now comes the fun, messy part. Let me move my wet palette somewhere real quick. All right, so we're gonna grab our Van Dyke Brown. Maybe. Where's that? Here we go. Yeah, it will be. I'm sure some people will come in right in the middle of it and they're like, what the hell is going on? But it's all good. Here comes the oils. Slide this up a little bit. There we go. All right, so now we're into the oil paints. So we're going to start off with our Van Dyke Brown from Van Gogh. This is their student line, but it's amazing. Oh goodness, there's another cap came off. Okay. And then we'll grab, oh man, did I throw away my good brush? I know. Yeah, I just got done licking brushes. I gotta watch that. Okay. So now we'll get some of our Van Dyke Brown here, and I'm gonna mix this thinner than usual. Because we did put those base coats underneath it. And if you've never seen this before, I'm telling you, it's going to look crazy, but stick with me. I promise it'll all work out in the end. A little bit more. There we go. Get it super. Go ahead, everybody. All right, now, here we go. Now this is creating a pre-glaze with the oils, and then we're gonna take our sponges, wipe it away, and we'll see how those colors look underneath it. Hopefully they're still there a little bit. We'll see. Detail comes out. A little bit more here. If anybody here knows Photos Mint, this is like his favorite part. Well, I don't think it's necessarily this part. I think the wiping away is his favorite part. Because it really is kind of like magic. Yeah, the magic. So when you see something cool painted online, don't necessarily think there were hours and hours put into it, because you might be mistaken. might have should have cut more sponges for this one. I'm really hoping those acrylic base coats weren't just a big waste of time, but I'm beginning to wonder. So this is... We've switched over to the oil paints. This is Van Dyke Brown from Van Gogh. What we do is we spread this all over, and then we go back in. Yeah. Then we go back in with some makeup sponges, and wipe it off. What it does, it kind of sits down in those recesses. It gives us some good shadows. And it also gives us a thin layer of oils, or a thin layer of oil, for the subsequent layers to lay on top of and work with. Promise it'll make sense in just a minute. Just gotta make sure I got everything covered. It's one of those things, if everything's not covered, the insider secrets, nah, that's no secret. I'm sure some people, that's the last step. That's the last step. We call that the varnish. So I think we got it pretty well covered there. Excuse me. So with that out of the way, there's that brush. I'm going to keep that one there. Right, yeah. Yeah, don't start with the spit, yeah. Yeah, that could be the issue. All right, so we got our makeup sponges. And I'll start down on the faces, just so you can kind of get an idea of how this works. It's pretty amazing. So we put the oil on there, just sloshed it all over the thing, right? And we'll start down in this area right here, and you'll see how much detail starts getting pulled out. And it really is, it's pretty awesome, not gonna lie. And I mean, this takes care of so much of the work for us. There wasn't a lot of color here, so not quite sure. Hey, you know what? Let me switch back. So that's that. The acrylics is what dries so fast. This is actually the first. Well, I can't say the first time. Yeah, pretty much the first time. Usually, what I'll do is I'll go. Well, hold on. So, I tell you what. Let me pause here for a minute. I'm gonna go grab a couple. Actually, here we go. So, like this one, this is 100% oils. This one pretty much was primer. Then I went over it with, thank you very much. This one was primer, and then I went over it with a little slurry of this straight over the primer, wiped it off, and went to painting. I've got a couple of in progress things here. I've been working on this. This is straight oils over primer. And then I've got the Moon Knight here. But everywhere you see the white is actually because of the oil pre-glaze of that Van Dyke brown. Everything that looks white is actually a yellow over top of the brown. Oh, thank y'all. Oh, you're too kind. Thank you very much. I really appreciate that. I really do. And then here's a Psylocke I'm working on. She's all oils. And then here's a Captain Marvel I'm in the process of doing. That's kind of dark, but she's all oils. Thank you. I really appreciate that. And then it's the last one. Then I'll get back to the Ninja Turtle. Here's a dragon I'm working on. This is done with all oils. So a few projects. 150 millimeter. Okay. Yeah, I can paint that. I think that's all I've got within reach. Oh, wait, hold on, one more. And then here's another one I'm working on. I've actually been working on her for a while, but she was painted with acrylics. And then I went over, started working on her skin tones with oils. So, I want a special table piece of each one of our Kickstarter letters. Hey, I'll do it for you, man. I really appreciate that. That means a lot. Well, this one actually came from, another Discord I'm part of, Atlas 3DSS. They do supports kind of like Table Flip does. And a lot of people were painting it in like, you know, the red and green and, you know, real Christmassy colors. And I wanted to go a little bit different. So I went with just a cold rather than Christmas colors. But that's kind of taking a back burner. And then, I'm sure you recognize this guy. There's what I've got done on Puck so far. Haven't made it too far. Just got some reds in on him. But that's the mascot for Table Flip Foundry. So, it's not. The red's definitely good. Like, the red, red. As of right now, I don't think it was really worth doing for the. For the other. Red. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's a. Yeah, Ty's good people. It's him and his wife run it, I believe. And I say this is the messy part because I don't think you can do this part without getting just like, paint all over you. Yeah, I can't either. It's just, I've just grown to accept it. Let's get a piece and let's take this shell down. See what it looks like. Yeah, I'm gonna do some dry brushing on that. But none of the acrylic came off, so small victories, I guess. The acrylics were worth it. I don't really think they were. Pretty sure. I don't think we'll be doing that again. Yeah, I agree. It does seem darker. And a lot darker than what I want, that's for sure. I mean, you can still, I don't know how well they're reading on the whatever screen everybody's watching, but I watch my painting through my webcam software, and it's still pretty dark there too. I mean, you can tell colors, but it's, yeah, nah, I don't know. Lesson learned. We can recover from it. Yeah, you're right about that, wife. Getting started on next. I did kind of want to do it in a grim dark style, and I mean the actual photo is, it's dark, but it sounded weird. Was that a car? Okay. drag off the tips of one of those swords. See what's going on. My shell's got some nice value to it. I mean, it's got the red and goes down, but oh, okay, we're good. That's enough of that. Let's point. So we'll go with a. What we got here? We'll try the Naples yellow for the highlighting the chest and the arm. And that really did help getting that stand to put these oil paints in. It really does make a difference having. Down like that. Grab this. And we'll grab. Oh, you're kidding me. Oh, sadness. Man, what is going on with these things? Start on the shell. Look at this. Ugh. Grab that. A little bit. Yeah, the color I'm putting down now is oil. Crazy, I got like that. That's probably the best consistency I've ever gotten out of oil paint. Yeah, I think it does. Looks like it does anyway. I'm not sure if I can make the same jumps that I normally do. but we're going to find out. Seems to be blended pretty well. I think it's coming out okay. Does it look all right on your screen? Oh, okay, good. Good, good. It's about time to get some glasses on. I know you did, thank you. I just haven't reached one yet. I don't think it's looking too bad. I've done worse. That's for sure. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the cheer, Secret. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. What it looks like. I really appreciate that. I don't think that's good there. All right. This one too first. Some bounce lights. Sure. That sounds good. I feel like if I say I'm putting in a bounce light, it makes me sound like I know what I'm doing and stuff. I think we might be able to use this to highlight these faces. See what that does. You really can't tell a lot of difference, can you? Can you tell the difference between the two of them? Maybe a little bit? I need to push that one more. We'll push that more. Okay. Alright, let's start hitting the green. What are we going to use for green? Here we go. We're going to try... I'll go back and brighten it up soon. All right, we're going to try radiant green. We're going to see how high, how fast we can push these highlights. We're going to see if we can just make it go. I'm going to go ahead and start right in the middle of his face. That way there's no take backs. So, let's grab a little bit. About to be a big job. Here we go. Actually, we'll start on the shoulder. It's a little bit easier to start on. Ooh-wee. Ah, look at how bright. bright that is. Holy cow. I'll try this one. Do, 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 do. I can tell the difference in person, but you can barely see that on the screen, I think. Actually, I don't. Wow, that didn't turn out too bad. All right. Well, sorry, I'm painting, and I had a brush in my mouth. I was really starting to question my decision on that light of a green, but I think it turned out pretty good. I think that lightened up. No, I didn't. I'm holding it. I didn't lick the brush. Licking oil paints is bad. You know what? We're going. Hold on. Watch this. We're going way out there now. Let's see if we found a way to. Speed it up a little bit.
No. Alright. Another brush. Here we go. Try this one. Hello.
I've come to harass you.
Uh-oh.
I wanted to see how green it was. It doesn't show up as green on my camera or on my screen. It's way greener on your screen.
Is it? Yeah, I don't know what's going on.
It might be my stuff. It looks good in person.
Thank you. Look at that. You see that? That is where... Pre-glaze didn't get worked out.
It looks good. I mean, you can even go green.
Yeah, it's hard to tell under the lights, though.
I'm still amazed you can do this.
Do it.
Just paint it
tiny. Well, it's not that tiny.
Pretty
tough.
I don't possess that talent.
Yeah, you do. I tell you what, I will print you something so you can test yourself.
If you print me something, I'll have to have googly eyes because that's the only way to actually get
things. I can totally give it googly eyes. Anything you want. That green's looking good. Yeah, that's not looking too bad. I kind of like the way that's looking. It's some ankle bones.
Yeah, I might do that. Just might do that. That would be pretty interesting. It's kind of nice having the it is kind of nice having the acrylics as kind of a I guess a color key of sorts. And that is a perk. It's coming out pretty good. Yeah, I think so. Yeah. I think it did. Ah. Get out of there, Brown. I don't like the way that turned out. You can still see it though, I guess. Alright, we can do, yeah, I don't know, let's see. I kinda wanna do something with that red. What do we got for red? We got quinacridone. Man. magenta, radiant red, champion red medium. What we got here? Permanent crimson. Let's try some permanent crimson. Sorry, I was leaning over. Looking at the paints. Woo, that is. See what we can do with it. That is some crimson. That's for sure. One second. I'm gonna have to go with a brighter red. Doing it. We're doing it. I mean, it's a bright red in the picture, so hopefully it's not too bright. We'll see what happens. This is really gonna punch up the brightness on this thing. Yeah, they are hard to keep straight. Hard to keep from getting muddied up. Yeah, that pumped it up. Nice. Nice, 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 nice. I like the way that came out. Matter of fact, we're going to see. There's a little bitty R right here. I don't know if y'all can see that. Pulled it out. Nice. Nice, nice. All right. So now, let me see. I kind of want to stay away from like purple. Here's quinacridone. Red. Ooh, that's not gonna work. That's too hard. Alright, let's try. We'll try the cadmium red medium here. As long as the reds are different. Well, there's not a big difference, is there? Is there any difference at all? Okay. Stuck in a place quinacridone. That actually looks a little bit redder. Yeah, I think that'll work. We'll go with it. Is it medicine time already? Holy cow, it's 8 o'clock. Alright, so... I'll have to go in a minute. But I think the lesson from today was... Skip the acrylics. Think in a way they help, but not so much in a way that it needs to be done. Looking better. All right, I'll try to get a little bit done on the shale, and then we'll probably call it. See, and I'm gonna go too bright, but I do want to brighten it up some. Black's not the color to do it with. What we got here? There's Terra Rosa. Let's try some Terra Rosa. We'll see if Terra Rosa lightens it up. All right. Okay, Secret. Hey, thanks for stopping by. I really appreciate it. Yeah, I didn't realize what time it was. It's after 8 here now. Yeah. Wouldn't that be grand? But yeah, I'll probably have to finish it off stream. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Yo, what's up? Good morning. You too, Secret. Take care. Yes. Yes, it is. Can I need your what? I think Dennis just came back. What was I getting ready to paint? I forgot. Okay. I'll try to hit up some of these metallics real quick. Hey, don't be talking like that in my channel. It just got blurry. It might have been because I was moving it back and forth and stuff. Yeah. Okay, yeah, it's just the camera adjusting. Okay, so I'm going... Ooh, not with that. Not today, Satan. Look at that. All that was about to end up on my silver. Ooh. All right, I'm getting ready to hit up the silver and that was done. What can I? This will work. And Dennis, these are actually metallic oil paints I'm using right here. Let me. Oh, this needs to go back this way. Somebody think. Yeah, this is actually metallic oil paint. Don't say. feel a difference there. It does make a difference. Thank you. Appreciate it. And it probably would have been further than this, but I wasted time doing a base coat of acrylics first and should not have. That was the last time for that. Thank you. Thank you both. Do you really? Your mom said last time it sounded like I had elevator music, so I kind of just picked something and went with it. Stone, that's not wiped off enough. Oh, can't get to it. Oh, there we go. Metal elevator music. All right, I think that's gonna have to be it for now. Hold on a second, I gotta do it. I can't just leave it undone. Oh, here's some brilliant yellow lights. It's right here. So, should I put the mask on that's like in the picture? Or should I leave the mask off? My mask gonna have to stay off for now anyway. Alright. Let's get this. Move it. Loosen this up. He's the anti-COVID turtle. All right. they're there. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's all we're going to have time for today. Because I've been streaming for a little over 3 hours now. This is the longest painting stream that I've done. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We are going to... Let's see who we're going to raid. We're going to raid somebody. Let's see. Yeah, he's the COVID fighting turtle. Yep, no mask. All right. Let me see here. We're going to go... Yeah, me too, man. Let's see here. The channel, let's go on. I think Wapelius is on. He is. All right, so here we go. We are going to raid James Wapple. Everyone, please hang around. He is an amazing painter. You will love what you see. All right. Thank you, everybody, for showing up. For those of you that stuck it out for the whole time, I appreciate it. So we're going to go check out James Wapple, see what he's up to. And I will see you all again at the next stream. Everyone have a good evening. Thank you. Thank you for the cheer.